My name is Doug Parker, host of the Cruise Radio Podcast, and this is a tour of MSC Cruises' private island, Ocean Cay MSC Marine Reserve. Before we get to the video, if you like this tour and you'd like to see more of them, subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. Ocean Cay is part of the Bimini Islands, which are located in the western end of the Bahamas. The island itself is located approximately 60 miles from PortMiami, which gives MSC the opportunity to stay until midnight and still make it back to Miami within a few hours for disembarkation. Now, before Ocean Cay was turned into the paradise it is today, it was previously an industrial sand excavation site that dates back all the way to 1970, so they've been dumping there for a while. Now, since the cleanup, which involved removing thousands of tons of scrap metal from the ocean floor and adding about 170,000 tons of rocks, the 95-acre island has been completely transformed. Fast forward to today, the greenery is starting to take, the palm trees and the shrubbery, and also the 64 square miles of marine reserve around Ocean Cay is really starting to thrive. So we'll start with docking at Ocean Cay MSC Marine Reserve. There's a pier here, so there's no need to worry about a tender operation and trying to wait in line to get off the ship. The ship docks and you walk straight off of it. Now, right now, there is only one ship that's able to dock at a time at the island, but with the growth of MSC Cruises, that probably could change in the coming years, but nothing's scheduled as of right now. Depending on the ship, there could be multiple gangways to disembark. For instance, on MSC Divina, you disembark from Deck 4, which is almost level with the pier. Once you disembark the ship and leave the secured ship area, you'll walk right into the Tours and Activities Pavilion. This is the spot where you'll meet your shore excursions to go snorkeling or one of the water sports like stand-up paddleboarding or jet skiing. Now, from this point, you can go one of two ways. If you keep walking straight, you'll walk through the Ocean Cay Village. That has a lot of upscale shops and sundries. Or you can walk left and head over to the lighthouse. We'll touch on Lighthouse Bay in a few moments. There is a tram system that runs throughout the island in case you don't want to walk from beach to beach. There's a handful of beaches here. All you have to do is pick up the tram at one of the many stops along the way. It's actually very easy to get your steps in on this island, too. Before noon, I had 2.5 miles, so yeah, really, I think I had like 8 miles by the time the ship left around midnight. Now, the stores on the island only accept ship card for payment, with the exception of the Bahamian artisan market. This area has items that are homemade and unique to the Bahamas. They only accept U.S. dollars at the market. Cruise cards are not accepted there. Every other shop, though, will accept your MSC cruise card. Now, if you keep walking straight, the stores will be on your left-hand side and the marina on your right-hand side. That's where the snorkeling boats are and the jet skis. And there's also Springer's Bar straight ahead. Right next to Springer's Bar is an ice cream shop. Really good ice cream, by the way. That's located like right next to the bar. Now, there are 7 rental shops around the island to pick up umbrellas, floating maps, also plenty of large bathrooms near each rental shop area. I should also mention that if you're a drink package person, you can use the drink package on the island. The island is pretty much an extension of the cruise ship as far as drink packages and prices are concerned, although they do have some cool like coconut drinks served in the Ocean Cay coconut once you're on the island, but they're about $10 or so. You'll also see a lot of colored buildings just behind the bar. You can't rent those, although a lot of people want to. This is actually the housing for the 120 employees that live on the island. The first beach you come to is Seeker's Family Cove. This area is dedicated for families and children of all ages. There's a rental shop at every beach as well with guests. They can get like water mats, umbrellas, things like that. You'll also find bathrooms and lockers and a lifeguard at every beach. There will soon be 2 food courts on Ocean Cay. Right now, the main one is located just off of Seeker's Family Cove. There are multiple stations here that have everything like beach barbecue, Bahamian food, burgers, salads, and fresh fruit. You'll also find a couple of drink stations as well. Now, there's also 6 food trucks scattered throughout the island, so you're never a few hundred feet from a food truck. The food trucks serve items like hot dogs, burgers, veggie burgers, fries, and sweets like brownies. As the island develops, those trucks will turn into specialty food trucks. Some could have an upcharge depending on what they serve. If the food options on the island don't sound appealing to you or you don't like what you see, you can always walk back on the ship, grab a slice of pizza, take a nap, and come back off the ship because you're here for like 12 hours, so you'll want to pace yourself on this island. Straight across from the food court, there's another beach, and that beach is protected by Ocean Cay Lagoon. This area is only accessible by a pedestrian bridge, and the beaches here are called Ocean House Beach and Bimini Beach. Ocean House is where the yacht club guests have their own little slice of paradise, along with an indoor restaurant. You'll also find three bars on this little section and the covered activities pavilion. Outside of the yacht club, all the other bars and activities are for everyone on this island. Now, if you're not staying in the yacht club, they do have cabanas for up to six people to rent throughout the beach. You can find them pretty much everywhere and on every beach. One thing to remember about this area, though, that is if you cross the passenger bridge to get to this beach, remember you have to cross it again to get back to the mainland. Bimini Beach is an island off of an island. My first time here, I thought it was all connected, so when I got to the very end of this barrier island, I had to turn around and walk back to the passenger bridge. Got myself in like another mile in there, but just good to know there. You'll want to pay attention to the signage around the island and get a good layout to figure out where you are and where you want to go. Back to the main part of the island, though, there's another long stretch of beach that is called North Beach and South Beach, taken from Miami. Both of those beaches are along the Ocean Cay Lagoon. Ocean Cay Lagoon is protected by a net, so you don't have to worry about big sea creatures swimming in here with you because they're not getting in. If you keep walking, that's where you'll find the spa at Ocean Cay and the wedding pavilion. They do offer spa specials and treatments right here on the beach, but you'll want to make reservations in advance for this because they do sell out. There's also a massive helicopter pad down here that doubles as a stargazing excursion at night because once the sun goes down, this is one of the darkest spots on the island. Now, from here, you can walk towards the lighthouse. The beauty of this lighthouse is how tall it is. If at any point during the day you think you're lost, which it would be super hard to do, but just look for the lighthouse and walk towards the light because the ship docks right next to the lighthouse. The long stretch of beach between the helicopter pad and the lighthouse is called Sunset Beach. You'll find a snorkeling station, another food truck, a couple of more bars with killer views, and a scuba diving center that's going to be here. At the base of the lighthouse, once you finally reach it, it serves cold drinks under a shaded area. You can also sit along a dock or step down to a dock that's almost at the water level. If there was a spot to take an Instagram-worthy photo on the island, as the kids call it these days, this would be the spot. It's also a perfect spot to get a picture with your drink and the cruise ship in the background. The lighthouse itself is 115 feet tall and 165 steps if you opt to climb into it. There's a relatively inexpensive excursion for around $12 for 30 minutes, and you can actually take some breathtaking views if you want to climb the lighthouse. There's a couple of resting points too as well, so you don't have to like do the big climb at one time. There's actually two platforms, like maybe a third of the way up and then two-thirds of the way up, then you're at the very top of the lighthouse. And once you're up at the top of the lighthouse, it's almost as good as taking a drone photo, which reminds me, don't try to fly your drone on the island. It's the quickest way to get it confiscated. I did get it back, by the way. So after you climb the lighthouse, from here you can walk back to the ship. You'll walk through Lighthouse Bay. This is another beach with lawn chairs, bean bags, a food truck, and of course, great views. Okay, so now that we've talked about the island by day, let's check it out by night. So how this works is you'll basically go back to the ship, have your dinner, then come back off the ship again for the nighttime fun. They kick the night off with a Junkanoo Beach Parade that starts by the Stringer Bar and ends at Lighthouse Bay with a big party. It's almost like a night in New Orleans without the stench of urine. Now, Lighthouse Bay really transforms into a killer beach party of a fire pit, a live DJ, dancing, and of course a killer light show projected from the lighthouse. Now, there are two different shows that happen on this lighthouse. They're about an hour apart, and when they're not doing a show, they project the equalizers from the DJ playing the music. So in a roundabout way, it projects the sound levels from the DJ that's spinning on the beach. It's pretty cool looking. A little side note, there are 23,000 little LED lights along the lighthouse that make this lighthouse show happen. If you do the lighthouse tour, you can actually see each little LED individually as you're climbing up. It's pretty extensive. If you're wondering about Wi-Fi on the island, there are routers on the island with the high-speed Wi-Fi, but like on the ship, it depends how many people are using it at the same time. If you have an international plan, it may work on the island. I use T-Mobile, and I had 3G and Edge network, depending on where I was on the island. I also had a Wi-Fi package, so I was able to kind of hop between cellular and Wi-Fi to get through the day and post pictures and things like that. Which, by the way, if you want to see some of those photos, check out the Cruise Radio News Facebook group or check out my Instagram at Cruise Radio. In closing here, a few first-time tips for visiting MSC Ocean Cay Marine Reserve. It's very large, 95 acres, like we mentioned earlier, so you may want to use the trams to get around, especially if you have a hard time walking. The drink package also works on the island, so it's an extension of the ship. Bring your beach towel on the island, especially at nighttime, because you may want to sit on the beach and watch the lighthouse light show. It is very popular. If you want quicker food service, try the food truck scattered around the island. Leave the sea life alone. You'll see lots of conchs and lots of shells and things. This is a protected marine reserve. Do not disturb it. If you're caught, you will have it confiscated, like my drone. Consider using reef-safe suntan lotion on the beaches. You can pick it up before you cruise wherever you shop, or you can pick it up on the island or on the ship. The beach massages were really popular. You might want to check those out. And if you have it in you, climb the lighthouse. It's inexpensive, like $12, 165 steps, 115 feet. Three platforms for photos. You'll really enjoy it. This isn't like the other private islands that some of the other cruise lines have, where you have to get off the ship early to claim your spot, because there are a handful of beaches on this island. There's, beaches along the lagoon, beaches along the ocean. Wherever you want to sit, you can go. And the further away you are, the less people will be there, because not everybody wants to walk on vacation. And I guess my final tip would be, pace yourself. It's a long day. You spend like 12 hours on this island, and no one wants to black out before the Junkanoo Beach party at nighttime, so keep that in mind. All right, that'll do it for the tour of Ocean Cay MSC Marine Reserve. My name is Doug Parker. I'm the host of the Cruise Radio Podcast and the daily Cruise Radio News Briefs. You can find both of those where you listen to your favorite podcast. Just search Cruise Radio or Cruise Radio News. If you like this video and you want to see more tours, subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. You are the reason why I do make these videos. What do you think about the MSC Ocean Cay Marine Reserve? Yes, not a lot of greenery on the island yet, but give it time. It's going to happen. These trees are just now taking, and within 6 months to 2 years, you will see lush greenery here on the island. But let me know what you think in the comments below. And thank you so much for watching.